Okay, equip that pulse grenade. Let's get back to business. Apparently I need some more sleep. Oh, it must have finally loaded. There they go. Stupid robots. Well, since I need to sleep, I guess I'll take the full 24 hours. Satellite array is not that hard to do, really. It's just, I'd rather be safe than sorry. Need all the bonuses I can get. Plus, there's plenty of food and water here. I do need to finish up this place. I'll show you a little bit of what I've been doing here. Oberlin Station's just a typical farm, though. That's why I don't even put high-end defenses here. The turret guns will cut down most of what's here with relative ease. Alright, that should take care of that. Good. Now I'll just hit one of them. Oh, I can't. This is basically the housing block. Simple. I got my radar dish right here. How many people do I have here? 11. Yeah, it's not a great settlement. Simple. I was going to put another floor, but I figured, meh. This is my garden, which I don't have enough people to run. Little bell tower up here. Don't know why I have it. I'm mostly just trying to finish out the roof. Once the roof is done, I'm done here. There's no real reason to come back. And the only reason why I build up all these spaces is just so I have some place to go to when I need it. Most of the gardening goes on down here. People rarely go upstairs. But I can get me some purified water while I'm here. A lot of purified water. So that's really all it is. It's just a little place for me to stop off, get something to eat and drink, and move on. Spend one night every now and then at the most. Yeah, I don't think I could fly across. Oh, there we go. I'll just take the bridge. Which, with the bridge, there's actually a nice little hidden secret in the bridge. I'll show it to you real quick. I rather like it. It should be here. Huh.
Hello. Hey, pal.
Hello.
Hey, how you doing, buddy?
Yeah?
Daddy, do you like my dress?
Charlie, you look beautiful. Just like a princess.
Nice little family trying to make their own out here.
Yes.
Ah, it's a shame. I wouldn't mind sending them off to my settlement. One of them, anyways. Anyways, in this little operations in here. Well, I'll show it off real quick. I'm not gonna go inside it, but it'll give you something to look at. This place is, once you get in here, you're like, oh, what the hell's going on? Why would I, what were they thinking? So there's not a lot of stuff here. Until you notice over here. Nice little reactor level. I'll go inside real quick. There's not a ton in the reactor area. It's not like its own little place. But in the reactor area, there is junk. Mostly junk. In here though, it's a treasure trove of junk. You get actually quite a bit of stuff. Nothing that's gonna keep you rich the whole time, but I remember there being a trunk in here. Where the hell's the trunk? Oh well, it's just a nifty little hidden area. If they'd put a bed down here, I would almost say it's a good place to just take a nap. But it's just a nice little hidden spot. Figure I'd show you. So now we gotta go up to the satellite array. There's usually two or three robots, a couple traps. It's nothing too bad. I actually like this little... this waterway system. I think it's pretty cool. Town up here is flooded. Lots and lots of ghouls. And up in this little cylinder underneath the collapsed overpass is a trader, typically. They'll trade you some goods. Cooking station, might need to use that in a little bit.
Best scrap in the Commonwealth right here.
Let's see what you have.
I'm out of 45s, I want to see if they have any. Oh, you weren't kidding, you only sell scrap, alright. Let's see. I'll get rid of one of these. I didn't really want to take any of the junk, there's no point. And where we're going might be visible by now. If not, it will be soon enough. It is a satellite array, which, when I first found the damn thing in the vanilla game without the DLC, I was thinking, what the hell were they thinking? Because it counted as a landmark, but it really wasn't anything. It was just two or three satellite dishes. And I was really disappointed that there was really nothing there, because in Fallout 3, there was a satellite array that was these three huge dishes, and it was turned into a raider camp. It was huge. I mean, it was one of my favorite raider camps, because you had to take all these little rickety walkways back and forth. There it is over there. You had to take all these rickety walkways, and it was dangerous because you could fall off and, you know, hit the ground and kill yourself. But it, when I first found this place, I'm like, oh, this isn't anything like that. And really, since then, there hasn't been anything like it. I haven't seen a satellite array that you could climb up into, and I'm kind of ticked about that. And I think I'm being followed. Oh, apparently not. Typically, there's dogs in this area. Now, with this, sometimes I try and do it stealthy, but I'm really not in the mood to try that, but yeah. We'll do our best, but these robots can really wear you down if they're well equipped. I remember there being two guns. Oh, there we go. Mr. Handybot. Simple enough. A Protectron Golem. Okay, I've been found out. I wish I had packed my plasma infused gauze rifle. That would really make short work of some of these guys. Now, while I'm here, I will be looking for armor. Particularly heavy armor. Okay, the caps I'll take. Robot left, and you don't have the armor I'm looking for, though. I thought he died, alright. There we go. VATS enhanced 10mm. Not bad, actually. Wait. I think I just took a weapon. I could break it down. These are the ones I want, the heavy armor. Now I can access master locks, and with the last one, my lockpicks won't break, which I should be able to get inside the building. I'll take the 45s. and the Assaultron helmet. That'll come in handy later on. And I'll give him back these mediocre pieces of shit weapons. And I don't think I took any armor. Sturdy combat. Yeah, that's gone. Reason why is because the heavy robot armor is some of the best armor in the game. Until you get to Far Harbor. And I'd rather have the armor than go to Far Harbor vanilla. Alright, let's get in there and take care of business. I just forgot to check. Okay, there actually is a hatch here. Alright. Not gonna bother, because I don't think it leads into the same place. Fort Hagen. Fort Hagen's full of traps, so you want to watch out. Typically, they're laser trip mines. They're laser trip wires that will trigger those Assaultron head lasers. They'll be strapped to poles. You gotta watch out for those things because they can really take you out. Find the Robo Brain. Easier said than done. Alright, I'm gonna stick. Well, yeah, I think I'll try with the shotgun. If it gets too hard, I'll switch things up a bit. Disarming those, I think, gives you energy cells. You know what, I'll use that pulse grenade now. Oh, that just doesn't do dick. This isn't my favorite kind of shotgun, but it does the trick. Okay, that should do it with him. Plasma cartridges, 44 rounds, and to hell with that. Plasma cells, those are what I need. Heavy robot, right arm. Once again, that's all I'm really taking is the heavy robot. Okay. Two down, three to go. I wish I had a kneecapper in this run. It would help me out a great deal. Okay, he probably has light armor. Plasma cartridges and 38s. Eh. Fusion cells. Fusion core and fusion cells. Nice. Yeah, he's got dick. This is far enough. Now, what could you be packing? Okay, let me see. Hitman 10mm. Ugh, they're really not packing anything really useful. Chest piece and a right arm. God, won't even give me the one I want. I always take these because you can always use them later. Yeah, I'm tearing through him like tissue paper. Probably wearing light armor as well. Yep. But I'll take the 45s because I'm gonna need them. Instead of taking the stairs. Now where I eventually end up is up in there. You're carrying too much. Alright. I'm guessing that my jerky wore off. There we go. Before we go down there, nice little thing for anyone who wants a full set. Mind you, this is level locked. I think you have to be 28 to 40. But there you are, a full set of XO power armor. Every single piece. Mark 3 too, nice. I might come back and take this. What am I kidding? Of course I'm gonna come back and take it. So, after finding that sweet set of armor, you now come in here, and you find exactly what you're looking for. The Robo Brain. There's one catch, and it's up there at the top of the stairs. And I'm not even gonna bother doing dialogue until it's dead. And there we go. The one thing that I was most afraid of having to fight is gone, which is Ahab. Ahab is a bitch if you don't know how to kill it. And I'll take the Ahab helm just for good measure. Shut up. And this is Jezebel. Not really.
That's a very specific part to be searching for, and you don't look like the typical part scavenger type to me. I calculate a 98.8% chance that you're looking for the mechanist.
What makes you say that?
And I usually am. Then perhaps we can help each other with our respective predicaments.
I could definitely use the help.
I thought you might say something like that. Now, how can I put this as simple as possible so someone at your processing speed can understand?
What a bitch.
In order to find the mechanist, you're going to need more than just my radar beacon. You're going to need access to the facility. I'm willing to provide said access, but you'll have to fulfill two simple conditions. One,
this will be good.
You need to get me as far away as you can from these lunatics. And two, find me a new body. Once both conditions are satisfied, I'll gladly provide you with everything you need. Do we have a deal?
Let me see.
How do I know you'll keep up your end of the bargain?
Even though there's a human brain floating in a bio gel inside my head, I'm still bound by my original programming. It pains me to admit it, but one of my directives states that I cannot lie. Ever. So... While I'm not the most charming robot you've ever encountered, the last thing I'm going to do is violate an agreement we've made. Now that we have that out of the way, do we have a deal?
Yeah, sure, we have a deal.
A wise decision.
Well, it's my only decision.
Once we're at our destination, I'll happily relinquish my radar beacon as a gesture of good faith. Now... I strongly suggest you stop loitering in the middle of a hostile location and get us both out of here at once.
Alright. We got Jezebel, now we're ready to get the heck out of here. Now, getting out's not as easy. They lock the door behind you. And they make you run through their own little funhouse.
Watch the trip wires. I'd rather keep myself intact today, thank you.
Well, in case you were ever curious, the tripwires will drop a ton of grenades down. And in survival mode, the odds of survival are pretty slim. Unless you're wearing really good power armor. And even then, you might not be so lucky. And since I've never tested it in survival, I don't want to risk it. Now let's see if we can't get out of here. I'm worried that my legs will cripple because I don't have the parts to repair him. No. Well. How come you can't get out of the power armor as gracefully when you're in combat? Yeah, that's what I thought. Worth a try, though. This room's a little dangerous. Luckily I'll be able to see where they're coming from. There they are. Come on. Give up the ghost. Alright, one of these was the legendary. I think it was this one. Nope, shotguns and 45s. Alright, 308s, always useful. Might have been this pilot. Dust. Cybernetic metal left leg. Man, they're really not giving me anything particularly good. And my armor's about busted. Let's check and see. Where's the rust of a raider body? I checked them all because I want that armor. Assaultron, heavy left leg, heavy right arm. Heavy left arm. Alright, I'm three away. You know what? I'm never going to use this. I'm going to start dumping stuff because I know I'm not going to use a good chunk of this stuff. The cryogenic, not even gonna bother using it. The metal chest piece. Resolute high capacity. Wind chambering, oh, hell with that. The hitman gone. Vats enhanced stuff gone. And I can eat the rest of the stuff. Alright, let's get back to work. And there's another bunch of tripwires here. Sometimes the robots set them off, though. And I don't think these will trigger if you have a high sneak. You especially don't want to trigger. Oh, you stupid bitch. As I was saying, you don't want to trigger that one because that will trigger this. And that could hurt a lot. Okay. Yeah, you don't have any of the parts I need either. I'm just trying to avoid as much damage as possible. Now the last room's actually going to help me with that to a point, because there's one character in there that's going to have something I will want and need.
Based on my limited experience with you, I estimate a 65% chance of making it out of here. Not optimal. An increase in effort could have an impact on the odds.
Okay.
This is the one sneak. That makes my head off. I demand we rip her head off. It's only fair.
I don't want my presence known until it absolutely has to be. Because once I start, I ain't stopping. Okay. Ivy's not the hard part. That
I would have killed her myself. Oh well. Six of one, half dozen of the other. Good job, human.
Okay. I want the I want the Tesla pieces.
Excellent.
Now the Teslas work in conjunction with the gun. Oh, good. I was worried about it being over encumbered. I'm good. Good to go on that then. Alright. Now there's also a mini nuke launcher and some mini nukes, so I'm not gonna bother. And in here there are some specialty items. An Assaultron blade, we have enough space. Mr. Handy Buzz Axe, which is useless. And this salvaged Assaultron head. And I'll go over why these are not so special items. On the return trip back to Hangman's Alley. So just to get, I'll put them all in the inventory just to make it easier. Except for the, yeah, and the Tesla. Alright. Oh, these load times. I just can't stand the load screens. They're always annoying.
Thank goodness we are out of that hole. Don't think your job is done. I refuse to cooperate until you provide a body that meets my standards.
Hey, you'll be lucky if you get a body that's not on fire. Anyway, since we have to take a long trip back, I figure I'll just talk about the different weapons and their pros and cons. The Assaultron Blade. This is actually a really cool looking sword. And I wish I could say it's as good as it looks, but it's pretty subpar, really. Yes, it is quite nice, and it looks neat, and you can put electrical attachments on it to make it meaner, but it does not have the same kind of kick that, like, Krell's Tooth has. Krell's Tooth is still my favorite melee weapon. The only other sword that I would say that's better than Krell's, or as close to Krell's as you could get, is General Chow's Revenge, which you can get really early. Matter of fact, I pass up buying it almost every time. And that's just because I have no real use for it currently. Though it would help with this little DLC. But the Assaultron Blade is, overall, it's an okay looking weapon. Maxed out, it's not too bad. But there's a lot of other better melee weapons. This is a good opening melee weapon to use, but endgame wise, I would avoid it. It has no real special traits to it. Oh, great place to test it out, actually. Yeah, see, even in power armor where it should be buffed, it isn't really that good. And then there's the Buzz Axe. This is more of that same old crap, and I'm not gonna use it too much. Oh, shit! And then we have the Assaultron head. Well, let me just show you what this can do. It's actually not too bad. But it's exactly like... I'm gonna die. Mine one. The only problem with this weapon is you have to charge it up, and then when you pull the trigger, well, you take a massive radiation dose. That's why I don't like it. Now as for the Tesla cannon, it's actually got a good kick. It's a pretty good laser weapon, if you're just looking for a good laser weapon. The problem with it lies... You know what? For this playthrough, I might not be able to actually claim that. Anyways, what I was gonna say is its main fault lies that it's not that powerful, but in survival, this might be a top contender weapon. Though then again, you have to use it in conjunction with Tesla armor. I really should have probably had her go to the Oberlin station. But out of all of them, the Tesla cannon's my favorite. The Assaultron head, it's just like a laser musket. You have to crank it. So you crank it once. That's what you get. You crank it twice. Charges up again. I think you can go up to 4, maybe 5. 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 5. And you don't get much for the radiation damage that you take, but this baby, I can honestly say, this might be the best damn weapon. Shit, this is exactly what I didn't want to happen. Luckily, I fell on a good side. Okay, I gotta get up. Uh-oh, I'm in too deep. Alright. I can't use the boost underwater. If I could, I would. That's why you want the jetpack. Just in case something like that happens. Alright, I gotta drink some water or I'm gonna dehydrate. So, as an energy weapon, this thing passes my tests. It passed all my major tests. The reason why the Tesla cannon's not that great normal is because it doesn't pack a huge punch, but this thing is pretty good in survival. As a matter of fact, I would say this weapon's probably worth the whole trip out here. Oh, don't tell me they killed those people. Okay, they just killed some scavengers. Not too bad, all things considered. I do have to get some more energy cells for this thing. I might just bring it with me inside the main thing. My only big gripe with this weapon is... Okay, I really do only have 39 cells. I was just checking. My only big gripe with this weapon is... It doesn't have a ton of upgrades. It's very limited on what you can upgrade. And the only things you could do is put a different scope on it, which... I prefer the other scope. And you can change out the barrel. This one's just the standard. The other three are, you can change it to an automatic, which isn't half bad. You can change it to a shotgun, which you can charge up and fire, which might be the better, really. And the last one, you can fire up these little energy orbs. Oh, here we go. What do we got? Rust Devils. Okay, against humans it's kind of weak. I accept weak though. What I like is that arc. It really is like an arcing kind of gun. And it really does do a good amount of damage. Yeah, there's no high-end robot parts. But, as you can see right there, it will chain lightning. Alright, there's that other barrel. There's also a barrel that can let you use it long range, but I'll never recommend it. Because the scope that you could put on this thing is really lame. Thank you. I'll have to get some more fusion cells before I can really use this thing. So here we are back at Hangman's Alley, which I'll probably do some major repairs here. But before I call it a night, I think I'll show off just what the Tesla can really do. And maybe show the other upgrades to the weapons. Oh, the Assaultron blade. Like I said, I like its design, but it only does 47 damage, and when upgraded, it does 47 damage plus 18 energy damage, which, even so, it only gives you a grand total of 65 damage. It's not that strong. And then the Mr. Handy Buzz Blade only does 14 damage, and upgraded with electronics only does about 36 damage. Wait, 32? What am I saying 36 for? It's about 32, maybe 32, 36, somewhere around there. I'm really tired. But the Tesla rifle, 56 base damage on a semi-auto barrel. You switch it to an automatic, goes up to 66, and has a better fire rate. Then you got the charging barrel, which is long range. This is pretty good, but it's only really good if you want to use it as a sniper, but I'll show you why it's not that great. Then the charged shotgun barrel, I recommend if you want massive damage, which I probably will switch it to, and then the lob barrel. But the reason why it's kind of useless is because you can only really get a reflex sight, which is crap. So I think I'll switch it to the... And that's the tactical Tesla rifle, which I think I'll rename. If you've ever played Star Wars Battlefront 2, you know the reference. That's all it reminds me of is the Dark Trooper cannon. And I think I'll also upgrade my armor while I'm here. The Assault-tron helmet. I really like the Assault-tron helmet, it's pretty good. And the heavy robot chest piece. These aren't my favorite armor types, but they work for what I need them for. I was hoping I'd be able to get all the parts in one run, but it's gonna take two or three repeat run-throughs just to get all those parts. But it's definitely an upgrade from what I was wearing. And until I get my... There we go. Yeah, and until I get my my marine armor... Yeah, I rather like it. All I really need is the leg pieces. The last little bit of thing I'll do is... Oh, I gotta do this for that one little bit. Put that there. Is a shelf a nifty little my preferred power armor. As much as I like the XO, sometimes the XO just needs a little bit of help. So, I'm gonna give it some Tesla pieces. Give it the military paint job. And I'll still have the same old pieces. It's just... Military paint, and then the Tesla torso. Give it the same military paint. When did I get the winter eyes? That's... Oh, right, it's a specialty. And with a few modifications, now I have pretty much the most powerful power armor you can make currently, until they put in some more power armor types. Well, that's going to end it for today. I'll be back again. We'll finish up Automatron, and then we'll start working on this main story so that we can tackle Far Harbor. So